Your merciful love, O God, we have received in the midst of your temple. Your praise, O God, like your name, reaches to the ends of the earth. Your right hand is filled with justice. Your merciful love, O God, we have received in the midst of your temple. Your praise, O God, like your name, reaches to the ends of the earth. Your right hand is filled with justice.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you all.
With your spirit.
Good morning, everyone. As you guessed, I'm the new guy. I'm Father Max, and it's a joy and an honor to be with you in many ways, and more as I meet more people, it's kind of like coming home for me, and I'll explain how that is during my homily this morning. But thank you so much for the warm welcome I've already received, especially from Seminary Jeff and from all of our staff, and already feeling very much at home. So, and welcome to everybody who's watching us via live stream as well. As we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let's first call to mind our sins and ask God's forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you ask us to seek your will and glory, not our own. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you fill our hearts with your spirit and life. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you challenge us to live with humility, trust, and grace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in the abasement of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy. For on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zechariah. Thus says the Lord, Rejoice heartily, O daughter Zion. Shout for joy, O daughter Jerusalem. See, your king shall come to you. A just savior is he, meek and riding on an ass, on a colt, the foal of an ass. He shall banish the chariot from Ephraim and the horse from Jerusalem. The warrior's bow shall be banished, and he shall proclaim peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea and from the river to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord.
I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. I will extol you, O my God and King. And I will bless your name forever and ever. Every day will I bless you, and I will praise your name forever and ever. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. The Lord is faithful in all his words and holy in all his works. The Lord lifts up all who are falling and raises up all who are bowed down. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, you are not in the flesh. On the contrary, you are in the Spirit, if only the Spirit of God dwells in you. Whoever does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. If the Spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, the one who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also, through his Spirit that dwells in you. Consequently, brothers and sisters, we are not debtors to the flesh to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. The word of the Lord.
Oh, Alleluia. Alleluia, Alleluia. Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. You have revealed to the little ones the mysteries of the kingdom. Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. At that time, Jesus exclaimed, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to little ones. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart. And you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy, and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, again, good morning. It is a joy and an honor to be with you, as I mentioned at the beginning of Mass, and it's a pleasure, actually. It's a pleasure. As you know, both Father DeTomo and I were a bit surprised by the moves, but we are convinced, too, that the Holy Spirit's involved in all of that, And so I know that many of you are going to deeply miss Father DeTomo, and of course, that's understandable. He's a fantastic priest. He's a wonderful pastor, so it's okay to miss him. He's going to miss you too. He loves you very much, just as you love him. I love the people of St. Mary's just as they love me. But praise God, love is not a finite thing. It's not like a pie, like you eat a piece of it and there's no more love to go around, right? There's plenty of love to go around, So we're going to do that with one another to be sure. But transitions and changes are never easy. So we'll just do it together. We'll pray together. We'll worship together. We'll get to know one another. And I won't even try to fill Father DeTomo's shoes. I won't even try to do that. If it's okay with you, I'll just wear my own. But let me tell you a little bit about myself, first of all. Please just feel free to call me Father Max. That's what I'm used to, and that's a lot easier than trying to pronounce my last name. My parents are Max Sr. and Marianne Streedle. My mother is originally from Milwaukee, and she's part German and part Polish. She's an only child, and my grandparents and her moved to Geneva when she was finishing up her high school years. She and my dad met at the University of Illinois down in Champaign when they were more or less set up on a blind date by my two grandfathers, who happened to both belong to the Knights of Columbus Council that Batavia and Geneva used to share, actually still do share. They now just celebrated their 57th wedding anniversary last month. In all those years, my mom has been one of the world's best homemakers, and my dad worked for a construction company in Des Plaines. When he retired from there, he actually took his dream job. He was an usher at Wrigley Field for about 10 years. Now, his timing was awful, though. His last year ushering was the last year before they won the World Series. So he just missed being there for the winning of the World Series. I was born and raised just next door in Batavia, as was my father, who, my dad's 100% German, and he's the oldest of four boys. But my dad lived his entire life in Batavia until he retired when they decided to downsize a little bit, and they moved into a new townhouse right over here in Pressbury in Sugar Grove. You know, I could not have asked for better parents. I could not have asked the Lord for better parents. And the same is true of my siblings as well. I'm 55 years old, and I'm the oldest of five. My only sister, Melissa, is a year younger than me, and she lives and works in Aurora. My brother Matthew is 51, And he lives with his wife and daughter in Sugar Grove as well, just down the road. My brother Mark is 47 and lives with his wife and two children up in Lake in the Hills, just north of Crystal Lake. And my youngest brother Mitchell is 41, and he lives with his wife and two sons in Wheaton. And it's such a happy coincidence then that I get to be closer to all my family by being here with you, my new parish family. I went to the public schools in Batavia and graduated from Batavia High School in 1983. Back in those years, I played football and baseball, and I was very active in the scouting program as well. In fact, my brother Matthew and my brother Mark and I all became Eagle Scouts. I started playing saxophone in the fifth grade, and I played all the way through college, actually, and into the seminary as well. But at this point, the last time I played was more than 15 years ago at my brother's wedding reception. Now, for a small fee, I might show you the video of that performance. I might. My home parish of Holy Cross in Batavia always played a huge role in the life of our family. And though I never really thought about the priesthood back in those days, I always did really admire our parish priests. They really inspired me. In particular, one priest, Monsignor William Donovan. Monsignor was 102 years old when he died in 1987. And he spent the last 50 years of his life living at Holy Cross in Batavia. Of course, those days are long gone, right, of a priest being around that long. But 50 years he was there in Batavia. And he had a deep love for the Lord, a beautiful love for our church, a wonderful love for the people of the parish, a fantastic memory, and a great sense of humor. Well into his 90s, you would see Monsignor walking in downtown Batavia, kind of twirling his cane on his side. He never used it to actually walk. He would just twirl it as he walked downtown, as he strolled. One time, very late in his life, just a few years before he died, my mother ran into him at one of the local grocery stores in Batavia, and he was buying those little individual containers of orange juice. And my mother said, "Monsignor, you know, you'll save a lot of money, get a lot more bang for your buck if you buy a gallon jug instead." And Monsignor just smiled at my mother and shook his head. He said, "Mary Ann, you know, at my age, you never know when you're going to go, and you don't want to leave too much in the fridge when you do, you know?" A wonderful priest, a great man, a great inspiration for me, too. After high school, I went to Purdue University in Indiana to study civil engineering, which is my father's background, and I graduated 4 years later with a degree in advertising instead. But it was at Purdue that I first started to think about the priesthood, mostly because of the great joy and kindness and holiness that I saw in one of the associate pastors there, a good friend of mine to this day, Father Ted. But I never really let myself consider it too seriously in those days, because like most college guys, I just presumed that I was going to graduate and get a job and get married and start my own family. So when I graduated from Purdue in 1987, I took a job with an advertising firm in Oak Park, and I worked there for 3 years. I was really happy what I was doing and enjoying it and doing well, but underneath it all, there was this kind of gnawing feeling that it wasn't what I was supposed to be doing for the rest of my life. So eventually, I just quit, decided to devote myself full-time to searching for a new job. Little did I know where that search was going to lead me at the time. But you know, God is very clever in terms of how he works with all the specific circumstances in our lives. So the first thing he did back then was he completely dried up the job market in my field. So I could not even get an interview, much less a job offer. You know, my job search was a complete and utter disaster. So since I had so much extra time on my hands, I started going to daily mass and praying a lot more and saying, "Lord, what do you want me to do with my life? What do you want me to do with my life?" And it was then that he raised the possibility again of the priesthood. It was as if the Lord was saying to me at every daily mass and every homily, every gospel I heard in my own prayer time, it was as if he was saying, "Okay, Max, now that I have your full and complete attention, let's talk about this." Well, eventually I talked to my parents about it. And of course, they were tremendously supportive. They were very encouraging about it all. But I still couldn't find the courage to talk to anyone else, to tell anyone else I was thinking about the priesthood or praying about it. Until one Sunday morning after Mass at Coffee and Donuts, where everything happens, right, at Coffee and Donuts, our pastor at the time, Father Stephen St. Jules, approached me and he asked me flat out, "Max, have you ever thought about the priesthood?" And I was just stunned. totally shocked that he asked me that question. But I had to admit, I said, yes, Father, actually I have been thinking about it and praying about it quite a bit. And we continued to talk about it over a cup of coffee and over a donut. And as we were talking, in my mind, in the background, I was thinking, this is an amazing sign from God. This is an amazing sign from God. You know, Father Steve is so holy, which he is. He's such a prayerful man. Certainly, he was probably in the middle of a holy hour. He was praying and meditating, and the Lord spoke to him and said, Father Steve, talk to Max Streetle Jr. about the priesthood. Well, eventually, years later, I found out that, in fact, he got a phone call from my mom. True story. He actually did. But I have no doubt that the Lord used both him and my mom to kind of move me along in the discernment process. You know, the Lord works in amazing ways, doesn't he? He can even work through conspiring moms and pastors, too. But after that, I started seeing evidence all over the place that God wanted me to be a priest. There weren't any lightning strikes, you know, no thunderbolts, no voices from the sky, just a lot of subtle, ordinary things and experiences and comments that when you added it all up, made it abundantly clear that the Lord wanted me to be a priest. At any rate, as they say, the rest is history. So a year and a half after I had that conversation with Father St. Jules, I was entering Mundelein Seminary, and 4 years later, I was the first class ordained by our brand new bishop then, Bishop Doran. And you know, I have not regretted it for one day since. I have not regretted it for one day since. Yes, for everybody, there are challenging days. There are challenging days. That's to be expected. That's to be expected. But I absolutely love being a parish priest. And I can promise you that I will be the best shepherd for you that I can possibly be. I will work very hard for you, and I will love you very deeply. I promise you that. It's a complete joy to be a priest. I'm honored, I'm humbled every day, actually, that the Lord asked me to do it. I'm sure Seminarian Jeff has the same thought, too. Just completely humbled that the Lord considers us for these sorts of things. And I'd say, Lord, thank you. Thank you. I don't deserve this. I don't deserve this. I haven't earned it, but thank you for the honor. Thank you for the great joy of being a priest. I wouldn't trade it for all the gold in the world. My first 4 years as a priest, I spent as an associate at Holy Family in Rockford. After that, I did 6 years of full-time schoolwork at St. Edward High School in Elgin, and I helped out at St. Catherine's in Dundee on the weekends at that time. After short stints as an associate both in Crystal Lake and in Cary, I was 6 years as the pastor in three farming communities in the northwestern part of our diocese, St. Joseph in Lena, St. Anne and Warren, and St. Joseph and Apple River, kind of up near the Wisconsin line. And of course, as you know, for the last 6 years, I've been joyfully the pastor at St. Mary's in Huntley, where I was very happy too, and I know I will be equally happy here as well. So now, happily, I find myself here with you at St. Gall's in Elburn, and I'm grateful that the Holy Spirit has allowed me to be here, that he's called me to be here with all of you. And I'm convinced that that's what he wants, and so that means that I wouldn't want anything else either right now myself. As I mentioned at the beginning of Mass, it's sort of like coming home for me then, too. So you've heard all the kind of area connections I have, you know, being close to my parents and my sister and my brother and his family now. And, you know, for 6 years, every week for my day off, I would drive through Elburn to my parents and back through it on the way back up to Huntley. So I watched this church being built brick by brick as it was being built. Quite a few times I saw Father DeTomo pulling out of the rectory of the driveway as I was driving by, right? You can't beat the bratwurst at Reims. And the wings at Schmidt's and the ice cream at Alice's, I've had all of that. Amazing Grace Antiques is my favorite antique shop in the entire world. I've spent way too much money in there over the years. Looking forward to doing more of that then too. And I was greatly honored to be able to say the funeral masses for my uncle and my aunt, both who lived west of Elburn. And I said those masses out of the old St. Gall Church. So again, it's kind of like coming home for me. And I appreciate how much at home you've all made me feel already. So thank you for the warm welcome. Thank you for all of your prayers and support. And I look forward to growing in the faith with you. Now, I know however long we're together, I look forward to that. Growing in our love for Christ and our love for our Catholic faith and our love for one another, love for our community and for our brothers and sisters. So we'll do that together. We'll do that together. And I'm looking forward to it with a lot of anticipation and eagerness and great joy. So thank you once again. And God bless you all. It's a joy to be here. Thank you. Together, let us profess our beautiful Catholic faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Jesus wants more than anything to help us in our daily lives. So confident in his love and guidance, we offer all of our prayers and petitions to our Heavenly Father.
For the church, that those among us who are wise and learned and prudent in the ways of the world may be converted and take their place among the little ones who understand the Heavenly Father. Let us pray to the Lord. That Jesus, who holds all power hidden in his peacefulness, may calm and pacify the hearts of the powerful, inclining them to thoughts of justice and reverence before the gift of human life. Let us pray to the Lord. That we who follow the just Savior, who is gentle and humble, yet whose dominion shall be from sea to sea, may imitate his lowliness and rejoice in his salvation. Let us pray to the Lord. For our dear ones who are far from the grace of God and his holy sacraments, that our prayers and love may bring them back to the Lord, who willingly lifts up those who are falling. Let us pray to the Lord. That the Lord, who is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness, may come to the aid of those who need him most in their time of illness and distress. Let us pray to the Lord. For our dear departed ones, in whom the spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead once dwelt by their baptism, that through the same spirit they may enter into new life in the kingdom of heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And for Irene Marie Hermes, the announced intention for this Mass, and for all our own personal intentions, we pause a moment in silence. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, you know and hear our deepest longings and concerns. Hear all of our prayers and help us to grow closer together as one family of faith. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Shepherd is, whose goodness faileth never. I nothing lack if I am his, and he is mine forever. Where streams of living water flow, my ransomed soul he leadeth, and where the verdant pastures grow with food celestial feedeth. Perverse and foolish oft I strayed, but yet in love he sought me, and on his shoulder gently laid, and home rejoicing brought me.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this oblation dedicated to your name purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so, with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And for those who are participating at home, we'll do an act of spiritual communion. Just let these words echo in your heart. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. As you know then, at the direction of the bishop, we're only able to distribute Holy Communion on the hand at this time, and hopefully that won't last a whole lot longer, but as you come forward, please make sure you don't have any gloves on to receive. Please also wait for the usher to dismiss you from your pew to come forward. Thank you.
Shelter. of his hand. The snare of the Father will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings your refuge, his faithfulness your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. You need not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day, though thousands fall about you, near you it shall not come, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. For to his angels he's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon your hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that having been replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Well, thank you again for being here today and praying with us, especially if this was your first time back since we started having larger crowds at Mass. Welcome back. Welcome back home. And thank you for the welcome you've extended to me. I will process out at the end of Mass and I'd be happy to greet you out in the parking lot afterwards. We can wear our masks and still do some social distancing out there then too. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Thanks be to God.
May Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls.
Skies for amber waves of grain, for purple mountains, majesties above the fruited plain. America, America, God shed his grace on thee and crown thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea. Oh, beautiful for pilgrim feet whose stern impassioned stress, a thoroughfare for freedom beat across the wilderness. America, America, God mend thine every flaw. Confirm thy soul in self-control, thy liberty.